Listen, I know I said I was gonna take a break. I can't do it. 2 weeks? 2 weeks off of caffeine. No, I can't do it. I'm sorry. I literally cannot do it. So, cheers. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. As you can tell by the title of this video, I am moving. I've moved around quite a bit for the past 2 years. I lived in Tampa, then I moved closer to my parents, and now I am moving to Michigan. Like, that sounds so crazy. And I've known this for 6 months, but still, hearing that come out of my mouth, it just sounds so random. There's so much to catch up on. Wow, like, where do we even start? How am I unprepared, even though I knew I was gonna be filming this? So let's start with why I'm moving to Michigan. Usually, influencers or YouTubers or whatever you really wanna consider me usually make the leap from their hometown to LA. You know, like, that's like the typical thing. But here I am, just going to Michigan. Super random. I've never been there. Why am I moving? Well, my boyfriend Dominic, we've been dating for a year and a half now. He majored in mechanical engineering, and while he was in university, he got an incredible job offer up in Michigan for 2 years. The benefits are absolutely insane, and I'm so proud of him for securing a position like this not even right outside of school, while he was still in school. I'm so beyond happy for him because this job will open so many doors. Obviously, I didn't have to move with him. This was all my decision whether I wanted to go up there or not, but I can work from anywhere, and honestly, I feel like the change of space will be good for me. And I know for some people, moving in after a year and a half is tricky and a little bit too soon. Obviously, this situation isn't ideal. Where we're moving to isn't necessarily ideal because we've never been there, and to live in a state that you've never really visited is kind of crazy. But I really love Dominic, not only as my partner, my better half, but also as a friend. We get along so well, and we've had like a mini live-in together trial period during quarantine where we're like living together, but it's like that extra step further because we're around each other 24/7, and we have got along perfectly, like shockingly so. Like, it's hard to get along with someone when you're with them for 24/7, but I mean, we've been together for like 3.5 months nonstop, and literally it's been a breeze. So that is why I'm moving. Am I happy about it? Yes, and then no at the exact same time. I'm gonna sound so dramatic, but when I tell you how excited I am to leave this house, I hate this place. Things I hate, it here. I hate this house. I hate the lighting. I hate the layout. I hate the useless space. I hate the location, and I hate the yard maintenance. When I tell you the HOA hates me and I hate them back, literally, we do not get along. I am not built out for taking care of a house just yet in my life. I am beyond ready to move, to have a functional space, to have something of my own, and to actually enjoy being in my house, which, you know, everybody should enjoy. But on the other hand, you don't need to move to Michigan to do all that, to just move into a new place. I will be missing my family and my friends like crazy. If I think about it too much, I will cry. So we won't dwell on that too much. Obviously, it's going to be hard. Literally, we talked about this for 4 seconds and I'm already about to start crying. What's going on? Stop it. I think it goes without saying that I will be visiting here a lot, as much as I can. I will take any excuse just to come and visit my family. Birthdays, holidays, obviously I'm going to be here, and Dominic's job is absolutely amazing in providing vacation time and guaranteed days off for the holidays, so I'm really excited for that. It'll still be a huge change.
Don't cry, 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 don't cry.
It'll still be a huge change because obviously right now I can visit my parents any time of the day, just to pop in, say hello, like quick 5-minute visit, or just stay for the entire night. So that's gonna be something that I'll have to get used to, not being able to do that. I'm trying really hard not to cry here, but life's an adventure, you know? I'm excited to explore a whole new state, to live in a different state for the first time in my life with Dominic. I'm actually super excited for the change of scenery because this house really took a toll on me emotionally, because I went through a lot of negative things in this house and the energy just kind of stuck, and it really had an effect on me, and I feel like it also transferred through to my content. So a huge thank you to those who have stuck around with me throughout these really weird times. I really appreciate you guys, and I'm getting emotional again. I'm sorry. Where are we moving? Well, we're moving to an apartment, to a beautiful decently sized, windows everywhere, perfect location, beautiful apartment. We're moving to an apartment, a beautiful apartment. Maybe I just had a really bad experience living in a home, but I am so beyond excited to live in an apartment. I'm so ready, guys. I can't wait to show you. But we're living in a mini downtown area in Michigan. It's close to stores, to the nightlife, to parks. When I tell you I am beyond excited, I'm like a little kid, but like 10 times worse. I'm so excited. I've literally made a layout on PicMonkey of the apartment, and I've been placing little pictures of the furniture I have now or furniture that I want all around this fake layout on my computer. You might call it deranged, but I just call it excited, okay? It might be a little bit much, okay? But I'm excited. Let me have this. Moving into this house, it was kind of a really rushed decision. Not much thought went into it. It was close to my parents. It had enough room for my friends to stay with me, but I lived in a fully furnished apartment in Tampa. So I had no furniture moving into this place. And since it was such a quick decision, I literally just bought random stuff. If it was on sale, I bought it, and nothing matches in this damn house. So I didn't really have time to pick the perfect pieces and really search for good furniture and really make this place my own, which is why there is no house tour. I don't know if you guys noticed this, but since I moved in here a year and a half ago, there has not been a furnished house tour or any house tour because it's just, it's not worth it. I know I've said this probably like a billion times in this video, but I cannot wait to move and make a place my own and make it homey and make it gorgeous and just inviting. Like, I have never made a wish list ever in my life, but I have literally made a wish list of all the furniture that I want for this apartment. That is how excited I am for this. I've been planning out everything. I've been orchestrating the perfect apartment. Of course, there's gonna be a moving vlog, and I really hope that goes smoothly because when you're moving from state all the way up to another state, I've never done it before, but something tells me, you know, you gotta kind of hope for the best, but expect the worst, you know? So hopefully that goes smoothly. There's gonna be an apartment tour, a completely furnished apartment tour, furniture hauls. I am so excited. And if you have any furniture recommendations, any furniture store recommendations, definitely drop it down in the comments below because that's what I'm on right now. That is my little kick. I'm on a furniture shopping kick. Or at least looking at furniture to get some inspo, so. Now let's talk about how and when we're moving. So the company that Dominic's working for is absolutely incredible with the benefits and with how they're going to help us move up there. They are hiring a moving company that is just gonna pick up all of our stuff, all of our cars, and they're paying for it. And this moving company is just gonna take everything and drop it off at our apartment, which I am beyond thankful for because if we had to deal with that ourselves, I'm sure it would be a headache and a half. And when I tell you they're taking everything, I literally mean all the furniture, clothes, our cars. I'm beyond thankful that they're dealing with this. But something that's gonna be a little bit difficult, and I'm sure this is just expected whenever you're just moving from state to state instead of like down the street or 2 hours away, is that the moving company will have to pick up all of our stuff like a week or so before we actually move in. So we're gonna have an empty house, no car, and we're most likely going to be living with my parents for that time, at least I am. They obviously need time to transport all of that stuff up there, so we're gonna give them a week before we actually fly in. We're gonna be flying up there, and Luna's going to be with me in the cabin, of course, because she's my child. I'm obviously going to be taking her with me. This is going to be her first plane ride, so I am incredibly nervous, but if you have any tips, let me know as well. Our lease starts in the beginning of July, and it is so freaking close. I have no idea how the time is flying by so fast. I could literally cry right now and it would be from both sadness and excitement. So that's how I'm feeling right now. I try to find the beauty in almost any situation, whether it's good or bad. Every experience is a learning one and a part of our life story. But when I say, I hate this house, when I tell you, I cannot wait to leave, when I say, I hate it here, boy, do I mean it. I'll keep you guys updated with the entire move, the process, the furniture, adjusting to a new state, snow. I'll have to deal with snow now and seasons. Like what? All right, guys, I'm gonna end the video here. Here's to new beginnings, new adventures, and doing it with the person you love. Thank you so, so much for watching. Remember, like, subscribe, all that good stuff, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Guys, I turned 24 in 3 days. What is going on? 24, where does the time go?